In this video, you will learn how to solve wind and water current problems. Now, when you're working with these kind of problems, they're typically going to have a very similar setup. So what I'm going to do is walk you through one example, and you can use that example to give you the thought process that is needed to solve any problems that you might see. So example one, we have a canoe can travel 8 miles with the current in 3 hours and against the current in 6 hours. Find the rate of the canoe in still water and the rate of the river. So for these kind of problems, we are dealing with rate and we're dealing with time. And so what I want to do is use my distance formula that says we have distance equals rate times time. We want to create a table as well to help us visualize what we're doing. So we have on the columns, rate times time equals distance. For the rows, we have with the current and against the current. Those are our two scenarios. All right, so the rate. So the rate with the current. You have the rate of the canoe. So let's call the canoe's rate, canoe, C-A-N-O-E. The canoe's rate, or speed, canoe's speed, we'll call that R. All right, and then the current's speed, we'll call that C. So if you add the canoe's speed with the current speed, that's going to give me the rate with the current. So I just simply do R plus C, and that is the rate with the current. Okay, and against the current, it's going to be the opposite. We have the canoe speed, so R, and subtract the current speed because the current is pushing against you. It's making you work harder, right? So if we do R minus C, that is your rate against the current. And then plug in your time. So the time is 3 hours with the current. So plug a 3 in right there. And against the current is 6, so plug a 6 right there. And then your distance. The distance is 8 for both of them, right? So distance is 8 for both. So from here, we have two different equations, rate times time equals distance. So we have 3 times R plus C equals 8. So our first equation is based off that. We have 3 times the R plus C, that equals 8. Rate times time equals distance. Second equation can be derived from the second row, rate times time, or we do times times rate, same thing. We do 6 times R minus C equals 8. All right, so those are my two equations, and we see those right here. All right, so I want to distribute, first of all, so we can do 3 times R and 3 times C. That gives me 3R plus 3C equals 8. Second equation, distribute as well, 6R minus 6C equals 8 as well. So I have distributed, and from here, I can try to get one of my variables to cancel by using the addition or subtraction method. But for that to work, I need to first multiply one of the equations by something, right? Because if I try to add right now, we have 3 plus 6, which doesn't cancel. 3 minus 6 doesn't cancel either. Same thing with the C's. Nothing will cancel if I try to add or subtract. So I first need to multiply. And either doesn't really matter which one we solve for, but let's look at the R's, for example. So we want the 3 with the R to become a 6. So to make that happen, I multiply the top and the bottom by, or sorry, the top by 2. So multiply the top equation by 2. So multiply everything by 2. We're going to get 6R plus 6C equals 16. And the bottom equation stays the same. All right, so at this point, we can do this different ways. If we can either subtract or add in this case, because the R's are both 6's, the C's are 6 and negative 6, it might be easier actually to solve for the C. where if we add these equations together, we have 6 plus negative 6, that would cancel out. So we have 6r plus 6r over here to get 12r, and 16 plus 8 is 24 over here. And I chose to add because if I try to subtract, people get confused many times with subtraction because they forget to subtract everything. So subtraction would have worked, and you would have gotten the r's to cancel out, right? 6r minus 6r. But then just be careful, because you'd be subtracting a negative 6c, which would have became a plus, and that would have became a 12c. So either is fine, just make sure you're careful if you're adding or subtracting. And from this point, we can solve for r by dividing both sides by 12. We now have r equals 24 over 12, which is 2. So r is 2, and I can use that to find c by plugging that into either equation. If I choose the first equation, we would have 6 times 2 plus 6c equals 16. All right, so solve for c. This is 12. We can then subtract 12 from both sides. We now have 6c equals 16 minus 12, which is 4. And then divide by 6. We now have c equals 4 over 6, which would equal 2 over 3. So we have concluded that r, which is the canoe's speed, is 2, and that's going to be in miles per hour. And the current speed is 2/3 miles per hour. And if you wanted to, we could double check by plugging 2 and 2/3 back in for r and for c, and we would find that that is the correct solution. So this example, we dealt with current of the water, but the same exact thing applies also for wind as well. So if you just replace the word current with wind, all right, so traveling with the wind or against the wind, it could be the same kind of setup where we have one where you add the wind speed, that's with the wind, and the other is subtracting the wind speed if you're going against the wind. And that concludes our lesson for today. We will see you next time.